First Defense Weather, the Southern Tier's only live and local weather source. Now, here's Chief Forecaster Dakota Hunter.
Well, as we take a look at the high temperatures across the area from yesterday, I hope you enjoyed it because we won't be seeing this again for at least a little while. 44 degrees was the official high yesterday in Jamestown, 46 Dunkirk. Look at Erie, almost 50 degrees out there yesterday, but Olean never made it out of the 30s yesterday. And this was the result of that warm front that pushed through the region, and that spiked temperatures over 10 degrees above average. We should be near 31 degrees this time of the year. Say goodbye to it because now we got to get into this. Lake effect snow returns tonight going into tomorrow. So here's all the data you need to know. So a winter storm watch is currently in effect for Chautauqua and Cattaraugus counties. That starts 1 a.m. tonight and lasts all the way until early on Saturday morning. Lake effect snow will start to set up later tonight, and then it'll last throughout the day on Friday. And the band's going to be meandering south-north. So it's not going to be stationary in one spot. And we think because it's going to be jogging a lot, that's going to help to keep down the snow accumulation a little bit, because it's not going to be throwing snow over one area for very long. Wind gusts could reach 40 miles an hour, causing some blowing snow once again. And the overall totals could be shovelable to plowable. We'll talk about what snow machine is spitting out here in just a second. So throughout the day today on Future Scan, the widespread snow we had is tapered off, and it'll last for just a few more scattered snow showers. You can see the evidence of that lake effect band setting shop right here tonight. And then again, you can see the band will sag to the south and start to impact the southern tier. But watch what happens throughout the day on Friday. The band will start to jog its way back to the north, and then by early Saturday morning, it looks like the band's going to be way to the north, probably impacting areas near Buffalo at that time before it'll ultimately move farther north and then just fizzle its way out throughout the day on Saturday. So snowfall accumulations from this, again, because we think the band is going to be moving a lot, that's going to help to keep down some of these snow totals. But we think a good maybe 6 to 8 inches of overall snow accumulation. And then once you rise up into the hills, maybe a good 9 to 10 inches. Of course, with lake effect, it's very localized. So anywhere you get those heavier snow bands, obviously you can probably tack on a little bit more to that. But 5 to 8, I think, is our general, is a good range right now, with probably upwards of 10 inches on the highest hills. But of course, we'll keep revising this as we continue to look at the newest data through tomorrow. So for today, widespread snow tapers off from west to east. A few leftover snow showers for the afternoon. High temperatures occur earlier this morning. We'll fall down to 22 to 28 before the day's done and over, with northwest wind 10 to 18. Of course, that cold front is bringing in colder air now. Snow showers tonight turn to that lake effect snow band. We'll probably have about 1 to 3 inches on the ground for the morning commute tomorrow morning. Nothing we can't handle here. 12 to 21 is the low temp range, with a pretty healthy wind of 15 to 25 miles per hour out of the west. Take a look at tomorrow. 16 is our forecasted high. And again, we're getting back down into this Arctic air as more Arctic air is dragged in, but that ain't nothing compared to what is coming our way next week. Signs point to significant cold air coming in late next week. Probably by this time next week, some spots will be back down into the single digit for highs, and some spots may not even make it out of the negative numbers.